Hello and welcome to Paint Shop Pro Basics episode 29. Today we're going to be covering the Lighten Darken tool. Now yes, you've probably noticed that my interface is a little bit different than it used to be. I'm currently running Paint Shop Pro version 13. If you want to try it out, I suggest you get the trial because they're still working out a lot of bugs. And apparently some people have not managed to run it at all. So, very quick tip. But most of the tools are the same, so we're just going to head right back into the Lighten Darken tool. Now, the Lighten Darken tool can be found underneath the paintbrush. If you don't see this little black-white gradient thing, just click on the right arrow, select Lighten Darken from the toolbar. You can also hit the L key. Okay, well, the Lighten Darken tool is pretty, it's pretty obvious what it does. The name pretty much gives it away. Lighten Darken. Wonder what that does. Yeah, it lightens and darkens areas using a paintbrush. It's pretty nice. We'll just get right into it. There are three main settings that affect how this brush works. There's the step, the opacity, and the mode. I want to get into all three of these really, really quick. Hopefully, we can get through this very fast. First thing I want to go through is left mouse button lightens your image, right mouse button darkens your image. It's closer to adding white or black than it is anything else. You can't darken a lightened portion and hope to get your image back. It's not going to work that way. So, just want you to be aware that you cannot undo your lighten with the darken option. So be careful. Another quick thing is that you can swap those keys if you prefer to darken with your left mouse button. You can just come up here to swap mouse buttons, click that, and it'll change your functionality for you. Very quick, very easy. Now, brush strokes with the darken lighten brush actually build up over time. And this is going to be easier to see when I increase my step here. Light, and it just keeps building up. Now that's just a single stroke. That's not like multiple strokes like we've seen with the paintbrush and other things. This is a single stroke. You can build up multiple strokes. Like it's almost like erasing to a white, but that's that. Okay. The maximum amount that a single stroke can get is up to your opacity setting. So we don't start off at 80% opacity. We start off a lot lighter, and it builds up to, you know, whatever your opacity setting is. In my case, 87. Your step determines how quickly that the brush builds up. For example, a step of 54, very light, very slow buildup, whereas if I kick this down to like 5, very quick buildup. So your step is very important in determining how quickly that maximum setting is reached. Okay, now they have a recommended setting of 10. That usually works pretty well for most people. Alright, so we've gone over our step and our opacity. Now we just have mode. Mode has two options, lightness and RGB. I'm going to make an assumption here, because I have not found any real documentation on it, that lightness refers to the hue saturation lightness values, and RGB refers to red, green, and blue. So, now, lightness is a more severe effect. It's really strong right off the bat. So if we come down here and look at that, very white. Now, using those same settings on RGB, take a look what happens. You notice very little difference by comparison. I mean, yeah, it's lightening things, but it's not as strong as the lightness effect. So that's pretty nice. Lightness is more severe, so if you want big bang in your face, use lightness. If you just want to gradually lighten things, use RGB. Pretty simple, pretty straightforward. and it's a great tool for lightening and darkening various portions of your image. But we're going to look at two tools in our next one, the dodge and burn tools, which allow you to lighten and darken your image as well, but their effects are a lot more controlled and they're not as severe as the lighten and darken tool. So stay tuned for that.